And we are on air. All right. I'm really excited for this. Let me, you know, do the thing routine. Check the sound. Make sure we sound in all right. Hang on. Let me get it up on here. We sound great. Okay. Let me make sure the audio is fixed on this side. It is, yeah, okay. Alright, cool. So, hello everybody and welcome to Darien Plays Alan Wake Remastered. I know nothing about this game other than bits and pieces of information that was given to me from our good friend of the podcast, John Spillman. He gave me bit of info that it... Can you stop doing that game? That it ties into the game Control, which I'm interested in. There's also an Alan Wake 2 coming out, which I'm very excited about, so I need to play this. I never played it. So, with that being said, yeah, we can go ahead and get into this, because I'm very excited. Very, very excited. Alright, here we go. Don't know anything about this game. New game. Normal.
Oh. Stephen King once wrote that nightmares exist...
Wait. Subtitles, please. Make sure everything's good on this end. Anything I can do with graphics? No. Film grain? I don't want a film grain. Well, we'll see. We'll come back to it, right? We'll come back to it. Is everything good? Yeah.
All right. Outside of logic, and there's little fun to be had in explanations. They're antithetical to the poetry of fear. In a horror story, the victim keeps asking why, but there can be no explanation, and there shouldn't be one. The unanswered mystery is what stays with us the longest, and is what we'll remember in the end. My name is Alan Wake. I'm a writer. I've always had a vivid imagination, but this dream unsettled me. It was wild and dark and weird, even by my standards.
Okay.
So yes, it began with a dream.
It all began with a dream.
Following a typical nightmare pattern, I was late, desperately trying to reach my destination, a lighthouse. For some urgent reason, I
all over the road.
I've been driving too fast down a yep. coastal road to get there.
Oh. Oh. Demonetized.
I'd seen the hitchhiker too late.
That sucks. It's over. Rest in peace.
He was dead.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
I was convinced they'd put me in jail and I would never see Alice again.
Alice. Who talking? Alice from Detroit Become Human? He's gone? What? What? Weird.
Suddenly, his body was gone.
I need to turn my audio up. Oh, hold on. Episode 1, Nightmare.
I was in shock from the crash. I could Ooh. Hardly stand my feet.
I don't see a film grain. Or am I looking at it? Well, I guess I do a little bit. It's not too bad. Reverse the controls for looking up and down. No. Let me turn my audio up, because my game is a little quiet. There we go. Oh, gosh, wait. Okay. It's kind of Dead by Daylight-esque. So, okay, let's, controls. Can I... The horizontal sensitivity is a little much. I like that better. So what is it? Is this like an exploring type game? Gosh, it's bright.
I had to go to the lighthouse. I knew there was something important waiting for me there.
Can I not go this way? Just want to see what's over here. There's something.
The bridge had collapsed.
Yep.
I'd have to find another way to the lighthouse.
Coffee thermos. 1 out of 100. Collectible thermos, really? I don't see a film grain. Let me see what the difference between film grain and non-film grain is in this. Here, let's do this. I don't... Maybe it's just for cutscenes? I don't know. Okay. Rain Cove Point Lighthouse Hiking Trail. We're going to the lighthouse. Let's do this. Whoa. Why? Whoa.
You don't even recognize me, do you, Ryder? You think you're God?
Whoa.
You think we just make up stuff? Play with people's lives and kill them? You think it adds to the drama?
Huh? Oh, crap. Am I supposed to... Okay, so I'm a writer.
It's not like your stories are any good. Not like they have any artistic merit. You're a lousy writer. Cheap thrills and pretentious shit. That's all you're good for. Just look at me. Look at your work.
So he's somebody that I wrote? Weird. Okay. Alright, no, I got it. Okay. What is going on? Man, the sky is moving? Is that what I'm saying? I'm missing? Controls are a little weird, but I'll probably get used to it.
You missed your deadline.
You can dodge enemy attacks.
From the story I've been working on.
How does it feel to die by the hands of your oppression?
Whoa, okay. We're going this way. Oh, I have stamina? I guess I have stamina. Yeah.
This way, this way. Hurry!
I'm here. Oh, there goes the bridge. There goes the bridge. Creepy. There. How do I get out?
Follow the light.
What if I...
You should go into the light.
I wanna...
You won't be safe there.
Stay in the safe room until you complete the light heals you, huh?
Well done. I have something important to tell you. It goes like this. For he did not know that beyond the lake he called home lies a deeper, darker ocean green, where waves are both wilder and more serene. To its ports I've been. To its ports I've been. Do you understand?
No.
Follow my light.
Okay. I got my game a little too loud. Hang on. Turn down a notch.
I entered your dreams to teach you. The darkness is dangerous. It's sleeping now. When it fills you clean, it will wake up. There's no time. I can only show you the most important thing. The hitchhiker has been taken over by the dark presence. You can't hurt him now. The darkness protects him from all harm. Only light can drive the darkness away and make him vulnerable again. Here, take the light.
Okay.
Turn your flashlight toward him and burn the darkness away. You did it. Now the darkness no longer protects him, but it's still inside, controlling him. He can't be saved. He's still a threat. He is still your enemy. Here, take the gun.
Gun. Oh, sweet. All right. Interesting.
Good. You've done well. Remember what I've taught you. That is all. I will give you back your dream now.
In the nightmare, a terrible darkness was taking over the world. The lighthouse was the last safe place on Earth.
All right, we're hitting up the lighthouse. Boosting the light with L2 blinds the enemies and burns the darkness away. Okay. Let's get some volume. Okay. Just a little bit. All right, we got a flashlight and we got a revolver. Whoa. Okay. All right. Yeah, I was planning on doing this stream with face cam using a capture card, but I'm still working on that, figuring out exactly how to do that. What is this? Flare gun ammo. Oh, thank you. Oh. Alright. So I got a weapon wheel. Moving on. Use some more ammo, but that's fine.
I can keep this up.
Forever. Alright, we gotta get up here somewhere. Let me get that. Okay, well, I was gonna stay out there, but while we're in the middle of the, right before we get into like anything crazy, I am gonna turn the game audio a little bit. It's a little loud. Can't really hear myself talk. Well then, we're in a nightmare, and all the things that he's written and whatever, it's. There's this darkness and it's trying to come after him, but why is the question? Where are we at? Where are we? Welcome to Bright Falls. Oh, we're on a ferry. Nice little quaint town, right? Maybe some mysterious secrets. Oh, this is us.
Let's act like we're on vacation. Go stand next to that old gentleman there. I want a shot of you with the town in the background.
Sure. I'll even give you a title for the shot. A city boy, moments before he got eaten by a bear. Hi.
Hello there. You picked a good time to visit our town. Deerfest is just 2 weeks away.
Deerfest, huh?
Come here, take a picture. Honey?
You have a lovely wife. If you don't mind me saying, I'm Pat Maine, by the way. Nice to meet you.
Yeah, I'm Alan Wake.
I won't pretend I don't recognize a famous writer such as yourself, Mr. Wake. A pleasure. I'm an avid reader myself. I hope this isn't too presumptuous of me.
Okay, so R3, pressing that down, switches the shoulders. Gotcha.
Look, Mr. Maine. I'm on vacation. In fact, I'd appreciate it if we could keep my being here just between the two of us. I'm sure you understand.
Fair enough. You can trust me to be this way. Not a hard man to track down if you change your mind, though. I hope you two have a lovely holiday.
Okay. So the end of the pictures? Or...
Very nice. I got a couple of really good ones. I see you made a friend. That's cute.
Right. Yeah?
Hey, bestseller. How's my favorite writer? Are you there yet?
Barry. Yeah. We just
got... Barry.
Are the locals giving you trouble? Just say the word and I'll hop on a plane and come make sure that
what is this, like, weird camera jumping this thing's
Barry,
doing?
Great. Great. Just want to make sure you...
Seat right there, it was.
Charmed. So, how is the place? Has it gotten your creative juices flowing?
Barry, we're just settling in.
Okay, Al. I'll call back later to make sure you're doing okay. And you call me if there's a problem, okay? Okay. Just looking out for you, buddy. Talk to you later.
I love you too, Barry.
You know he's going to be calling you every 5 minutes.
Barry is Barry. I can always turn off the phone.
What did I tell you?
Text message from Barry. He says hi to you too.
I want to see what's over here. I want
to
see what's up here. It's nothing. What about that side? There's always something. Secrets. I don't know if this is like a one of them games. I can't get up there. Why can't I go up here? But I can't go. Okay. Back to the. I'm at the car. This is our car.
We need to stop
at the local diner to get the cabin key from the landlord, a Mr. Carl Stuckey. He's waiting for us.
Mr. Carl Stuckey.
I'll go fill her up while you get the key. I'll pick you up here in, say, 15 minutes?
Sure.
Sounds like a play. I don't know her name.
Thank you for coming here with me.
I love you too. Go on. I'll promise to behave.
Well?
I've forgotten there were still places like this.
It's
towns where everybody knew everybody.
Welcome to the O'Dear Diner.
Hi, I was wondering if you could help me. I'm looking for...
Mr. Wake. Alan Wake. Oh, God! I am your biggest fan. I know people say that all the time, but I really am.
I'm glad to hear that.
Rose.
Rose, I'm looking for Mr. Stuckey. Carl Stuckey?
Carl? Of course, Mr. Wake. He must have gone to visit the restroom. He'll be back in a moment. I can't believe it.
Okay.
I've got all your books.
Who was that?
What's going on? I got the cutout from the bookstore when they took it out of the window.
I see that.
And you keep it here. Well, okay. Good for you.
Right. So much for a quiet vacation.
It's kind of nice.
Do me a favor,
Sonny. Nick Fury.
I could really use a tune right now. Coconut number 6 in the jukebox.
Bro, it's
myself, but both of my legs have gone to sleep. Bad circulation.
Yeah. Bro, just turn around and...
Coconut again?
I'll play coconut.
Call yourself a rocker. Unbelievable. It does that. Get stuck. Yeah, you need to give it a good solid whack. Now that's what I'm talking about, yes!
Be nice.
This is it. I've died and gone to hell.
Voice actor sounds familiar. It might just be me, though. Huh? This game kind of reminds me of, a little bit of Mafia. In a way, the Mafia games, just a little bit, but not really. You know? Okay, I guess I have to go around the other way. Can I run? I'm gonna find Carl Stuckey. Look at this guy, living his life. That's funny. Can I go and step on him? Hey, give me that. You okay, sir?
I didn't want to wait. I wanted to find Stuckey, to get the key and get out as soon as possible.
It is dark.
The waitress was giving me a headache. Overeager fans always did.
This guy don't like his fans? Okay. Knock. Oh, cutscene.
Hello? Mr. Stuckey?
Don't tell me he's, like, dead in the bathroom or something.
Carl couldn't make it. Unfortunately, he was taken ill. But I have the key for you and instructions on how to get to the lake.
I heard, recognize her voice, too.
I wish you a good stay in my cabin. I'll come by later to check how you've settled in. And to meet your wife.
Hmm?
I insist.
Thanks.
Okay. Thank you.
Cauldron Lake is a special place. Very inspiring.
You got lucky this time, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
Even that sounds better than your singing.
Are you all right?
Splendid, splendid! Damn hernia. It swells up like a balloon if I lift anything heavier than its boom. Yep. Splendid, splendid. It's been a long time, Tom. Good to see you.
Hey, you wouldn't happen to have a bottle on, would you, Tom?
I wish.
This is Mike from Breaking Bad, isn't it? Sounds exactly like him.
The Andersons. They're local musicians.
We're waiting for Dr. Hartman to come pick them up. They wandered off from his clinic at the Cauldron Lake Lodge.
Wait. Okay. It's been 15 minutes already. That was a random piece of information that copied me.
The key and the directions.
My hero. I got some flashlights, just in case.
Oh, jeez. Who's this?
Hey,
Mr. Stucky?
Mrs. Wake! Your keys!
Uh-oh.
That diner was a real nut house.
I don't have this. Now what?
This would make a wonderful setting for a book.
We're supposed to be on vacation, Alice. I'll figure it out when we get back home. Okay?
Okay.
Speaking of book, I might do some writing here in a little bit.
Batman here on PBFF.
I didn't want to talk about it. I wanted to bury my head in sand.
Here's another one of my favorites to go with it.
Once upon a time, I was a successful writer, but that was a long time ago. I hadn't been able to write a word in 2 years, not since my last book.
So we're getting a trailer for The Nun 2 tomorrow. I don't know if you guys have seen that movie in the Conjuring universe. I like the first one. So I'm excited to see that. I'm supposedly getting a new trailer for The Marvels and a new Blue Beetle trailer.
Right. Don't worry, honey. I'll get you inside safe and sound before it gets dark. And I'll get the flashlight.
Oh, yeah.
I'm okay.
Alice
had a phobia. The fear of darkness. I wanted to make sure we were inside with the lights on before sunset.
Gotcha. Hey, don't worry. Don't you worry, Alice, because I got the flashlight, and I can do crazy things with the flashlight. You should see me at the beginning again. Banishing dark people and stuff. That sounds wrong. Dark entities, whatever they were. But they were like hitchhikers, but they had darkness. I don't know. Bird Leg Cabin. It's kind of, okay. I don't know if this is one of those games where I need to explore every little inch, but I mean, I'll do it. Just for the sake of it, you know? I'll hit up the porch in a minute. I'm gonna go around. Cellar door. It's a Jason Voorhees' shed. I'm gonna find his mom's head in here. What is that? No, I can't open this door, can I? Oh, I can't.
Generator had been connected to the power cable.
Oh. I didn't even know that was my goal, but here we are. What did I get for exploring?
Alice had told me about Cauldron Lake Lodge.
Gorgeous.
The old building used to be a hotel. But these days, it was no longer open to the public.
Okay, I'll look around a bit.
Sure thing. Have fun.
Don't go dark. I want to keep looking. Oh. You can look around for me.
It was a beautiful place. I told myself I could rest here, sleep here, and forget about my work. I thought we could be happy here.
She's gonna die, isn't she? Return to Alice. Okay. Bright light.
Alice?
The door shuts on
Sunny.
She's out on a porch. Well, I want to look around the house first. Look at that. That's why we look. However many that is out of. You're upstairs, then why is this door open? What? Okay, let me hit it.
The Deer Fest guests have already started to arrive. Just ran into one.
It's kind of a nice place, though. I mean, here's the thing, it's nice.
We'll see if we can rope them into an interview later on.
I just saw him at the diner. Oh, I am so excited he's here.
I'm sure he's glad to be here, too. Well, folks, I guess the secret's out. This is Pat Main on KBFFM.
That was, okay, so it's older, that older guy from the boat. Yeah. Okay, we'll go upstairs and talk to Alice. Did we check? We check. Yep. I'm on my way. Okay. No. Okay. Oh, we're gonna go.
Surprise!
Alice, what is this?
I guess I have a small confession to make. I thought maybe you could write here that a change of scenery would get you past.
Damn, Alice, you. Everyone
hey, just hear me out. There's a local doctor, Dr. Hartman. I read a book of his. He has a private clinic here. He specializes in helping artists.
So now you want to get me committed?
No, it's not what? Like that. That's not...
Not great.
Alan?
I don't, just don't. I don't want to hear it. God damn it, Alice. God damn it. I knew she wouldn't follow me in the dark. I needed some time alone to think things through.
How we fall? Just fall down, whatever. Diver's aisle.
Oops.
Oh God. Why aren't you running right when you start screaming? What are you doing?
All the lights were out.
I'm coming. I'm on my way. Birds.
Alice, I'm coming. It's all right. I'm coming.
No!
What the hell?
Alan, help me!
I'm coming.
Alice?
Oh. Oh my gosh. I knew she was something was gonna happen to her. She did.
Oh no!
Oh no! Jump!
Keep going, Alice.
Oh god.
Wake up.
Alice? Waking up in the crashed car felt like I had woken from one nightmare and entered another. I couldn't remember how I got there. All I knew was that something terrible had happened to Alice. The phone was dead. I'd have to find help on foot.
This is kind of crazy. How did I... Where... What? Creator's Dilemma. Stucky's Country Store. And guess. Okay. I guess we... That's too far of a drop. No, we'll probably go around the car. Wait, what? Examine what?
Among Alice's things was a book, The Creator's Dilemma, by a Dr. Emil Hartman. Seeing the book brought back my fight with Alice. I didn't like it, and I didn't like the guy's smug face on the cover either.
Okay.
The gas station was my best bet. They'd have a phone I could use. It looked like a long hike through the forest to get there.
This is kind of weird. I was told that this game...
Damn.
Oh. Well, can I go to the car? I was told that this game has a lot of, a lot of vibes similar to games like, I mean not games, shows like Twin Peaks, David Lynch and stuff like that, with that kind of weird tone and whatnot. So I'm interested. So far it's grabbed me a little bit. It's a little slow. 35 minutes in. What does that say? After waking up behind the wheel of a crashed car, no clear memory of what has transpired. Awake heads for a gas station. Okay.
Hello?
Hello? Oh, gosh. End of the light. Oh, it's very bright.
Hello? Someone there?
It's like a car or something? What is this?
The loose sheets of paper were pages from a manuscript entitled Departure. That was the name I planned to use for the next novel I had never gotten started. I was named the author. I hadn't written it. I couldn't remember writing it. In the scene on the page, the hero was attacked by an axe murderer in the woods at night.
Oh, great. Is that foreshadowing? Oh, sweet Jesus. Okay. No, we're cool.
Anybody there? Please, I've been in an accident.
They don't care. That looks like it. Reach the gas station. That's the plan.
The lights up ahead were a good sign. Maybe I wouldn't have to hike all the way down to the gas station to find a phone.
Where's the gas station again? Is it farther? I guess it's somewhere else. Okay. I guess we're climbing up this tree.
Anybody there? Please! I've been in an accident! Hey!
Nope.
Hey, you! Failed. There's been an accident! I need help! Listen, I need to...
Premium cabins for rent in...
Oh, hell.
Carl Stuckey.
Pleased
to meet you. Non-refundable
reservation
deposit required. Fair and square.
Well, that's Mr. Stuckey.
Fair and square.
He's not in here, is he?
Knocking on the door with his axe like Nicholson in The Shining.
He already is. Hey, there we go. Oh, yeah. Signature weapon up in here.
During your trying it's the latest thing. Incontestably proven! Let you...
Yes.
Shoot!
Bright Falls Sheriff Station.
Hello?
Cholesterol level!
The spirit.
Yeah, you think? Gosh, is he pushing the place off of the, Yeah, thank you for that.
There were more of them.
Outside a shooting range, and now I just kill someone or something.
Do they drop ammo?
It just disappeared.
Or do I need to like search for ammo?
It felt real enough to make me
sick. I don't
know.
Here, we'll look. Okay. Is that ammo right there? Something shiny. Yeah. Okay, so keep looking for that. Ammo is shiny. Shiny, shiny. Kick it. What did that do?
The dark forest was the last place I wanted to go, but I had no choice. I had to get to the gas station.
Well, we'll figure it. Oh! You know what? That is what you get. Right there, that's what you get. Over here. Come on. Alright, what's up here? There's like a secondary path. With a manuscript page? Yes, okay. And then no ammo. No ammo for your boy. Not at all. Okay. No, no, it's cool. I understand. I get it. Let's see how it is. Speaking of, though. Load that. Reach the gas station. Close to the gas station at... Oh. Okay, visions. Like mafia meets the quarry or something.
I saw the river below. Something uncoiled itself inside my head. I realized that I'd have to find a way across.
Well, we found a way across.
I didn't even look at the water.
I keep thinking I see some shinies, and it's not. Gas station's kind of far.
Stucky was still out there, in the dark, stalking me.
Stalking Stucky. I didn't even see that. Alright, let's, Oh my god! I like the gum combat. It's kind of crazy. Whenever multiple coming at you, you gotta kind of switch back and forth between figuring out who you want to hit with the flashlight, but I'm here for it though. I like it. What's this procedure under this logging area? Great. We're going this way. We're running, actually. We're running.
The staircase was broken.
Nope.
I had to make my way up some other way.
It's always something wrong that I can't go up the correct way. Now I gotta go through the creepy fog. Hopefully find a path. Oh, there's a... Hold up. Coffee thermos. That one time. Alright. Do you see... You guys see... Oh, I see something green over here. Might be a button I gotta press. Generator, looks like. Maybe some ammo in one of these buildings, too. Oh, man. What? Okay. See, that was a close one. But well, we're all, we good. We are good. Lights cutting up, coming on or something? What is... Okay. Let's go in here. Yep. Manuscript page. Ooh. Yeah, let's get that. Yeah, I like that. I like that. Cool, we got a shotgun. We're still not gonna use it. We don't have much ammo. We have two shots. I don't call that worth. It's not really worth it. At the moment. But it will be. It probably will be very useful. Can I climb that? Okay. Oh, wait, I bet this is for something I have to do with this, right? Maybe? Possible. Yeah. Yep. Okay, now I climb up. Okay, so some puzzles in this game, too. Good to know. Dude, really? Is there a way I can change that? Can I, like... I don't know. We'll see if how this works, right? There we go. We gotta get a little run and jump going there. Alright. Alright, okay. We're not near the gas station yet. Driving me nuts. Shotgun ammo.
Well, I was just outside for a breath of fresh air, and what a night I had. I know most of you are probably in your beds by now, but if you're still up and around, take a moment. Step outside for a spell and breathe in deep. The weather is absolutely still. The sky is crystal clear. It's like the forest is quietly breathing along with you. You listeners know I'm a night owl, and it's on nights like this I wish I wasn't cooped up in the studio. Makes an old man like me wish I could just roam wild. But here I am, and who'd keep you company all night long if I weren't? It looks like I'm not the only one staying up late. Caller, you're on the air.
Hey, Pat, it's Maurice Horton.
Hello, Maurice. What are you up to?
Well, I was just taking Toby on his walking.
Oh, isn't it beautiful out there?
Sure, but Pat, the reason I called is that Toby heard something rustling in the undergrowth and took off after it, and I couldn't find it.
Probably a rabbit.
Sure. Toby loves rabbits.
Well, sure.
Anyway, I figured that, you know, if anyone runs into Toby, they could grab him. My number's on his collar.
And Toby's a friendly dog?
Toby loves people. Usually he comes back, but we were pretty far from home, and it sounds like he went pretty wild there. Great dog, but come for his own good.
Well, Maurice, it's out there now. Hope Toby comes home soon.
Yeah, thanks.
You have a good night now.
Well, missing dog or cat. I think it's a dog. There's so many rumors going on right now about some Marvel and DC stuff. I was reading some of that while I was listening to that radio. Reed Richards, all this casting rumors. And Adam Driver's in, Adam Driver's out. Adam Driver's supposedly back at the table again.
Was closer now. My it's Lord. Like welcoming in the darkness.
Paul makes the best drawers. Belly Burster is the best with no curves.
Monster Dog
is second best. The famous dog is...
If they throw one more axe at me. I'm very angry. What is that? Batteries. Useful. Is that the gas station? Because that thing's extremely far away. I surely hope not. Okay. Well, apparently it's this way, so maybe it's not. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god, oh my god. Alan. 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 They really, that scared the crap out of me. I gotta be honest, I did not expect that. This wants me to go up this way. Okay. Yeah, let me get the heal out real quick. Alright, open that. Get some of that. Alright. There you go, we got that one bullet. I wonder what kind of monstrosity is waiting for me right here. Lithium batteries, shotgun ammo. A second shotgun? I don't need a second shotgun, oh. Okay, I guess I do. Can I hit him? Blocking the TV, get out of it. The price for such a legacy is steep indeed. In Night Springs. Tonight's episode, a quantum suicide. If our lives are already written, it would take a courageous man to change the script. Having called a press conference, Dr. Barclay... I'm not watching that. This is a boss battle. Oh, I keep forgetting the dodge button. Fast.
Oh.
Is that it? Nordic walking. Unlike Stucky, you enjoy incontestable health benefits, namely, you're not dead.
Stucky's body vanished, leaving behind only a lifetime of nightmares to come. Assuming I'd reach the lights at the gas station alive.
Yeah. Let's keep on trucking. I saw a little silhouette of a coffee thermos. Okay. Here we go. Yeah, like I said though earlier, I was gonna do face cam for this, but I was still trying to figure out how this capture card works, and I also need a longer HDMI cable, so I'm gonna hold off on that. But it is very close to happening. I have the capture card in my possession. We made it.
I recognized the parade float I had seen in Bright Falls when I first arrived with Alice.
Sweet.
After the insanity I had just experienced in the darkness, the lights of the gas station felt comforting. At least for a moment, the sane world reasserted itself.
We made it.
The Deer Fest had been 2 weeks away when we arrived. If the day count on the banner was right, I was missing a whole week between the night we got here and now.
Huh. I guess the front door's locked. Yeah. Alright, we'll go through the garage then. Breakers, farm, apples.
The garage was a mess. It looked like someone had trashed the place, or that there'd been some kind of fight. Alright. I'll keep writing. Outside, there's only darkness. Outside the cabin, outside the story, there's only darkness. I can feel her presence in the dark. Just now, I could smell her perfume in the room. I'll reach her, I'll fix it up. I'll bring her back. The story will come true. If I stop, she's lost. I don't believe this. It'd been me on the TV, talking crazy. Was I losing my mind?
Here, one second. I think there is a small bug on my TV screen, and I want it to go away. Okay. That was easy enough. Cool. We're not gonna end it just yet. Just kinda situating myself here. How are we at? 58 minutes? I was gonna say, after finding strange manuscript pages that seem like his own handiwork, Wake comes under brutal attack by strange shadowy men, fights for his life as he makes his way toward the gas station. And we made our way towards the gas station. We're here. We could end it now. What is this? Ooh. 68th Annual Deer Fest, September 15th to 18th. Games and activities, raffle tickets, fishing competition, pie contests, surprise competitions, live music for the children, Bucktooth Charlie afternoons, and Montgomery the Mystic's amazing Phantasmagoria evenings. Don't miss the legendary Deer Fest parade. Huh. A Nordic walking thing up there. Read what? Read what? Game. Oh, it's still that. Okay. Do they have a phone? They do. I think we might actually end it here. It seems like a good spot, right? So, yeah, I can't show Alan Wake's face, so we're just here. So, yeah, thank you all so much for joining me for this episode. If you enjoyed the game, leave a like, comment, tell me other games I should play after this, and what your thoughts are so far, and if you like the game already, if you've played it. Don't spoil it, obviously, but yeah. And let me think of anything else. We have a new extra beef that's out right now, Batman Under the Red Hood. It also has our new format for the episodes, which I hope you really like. I know I do. And obviously we'll get another format soon in the form of video. I'm very excited about that. I mean, it's already video, but you know what I mean, camera. Right, you'll see our faces, our lovely faces. And, so that's happening. I'll do another stream of this tomorrow, I think. Maybe tomorrow. Anything else? I don't know if Landon's planning on doing a stream or not. But, yeah, we also have the normal episode of the podcast that's out, which you guys can also check out, where we talk about the Superman casting and all kinds of other stuff. So, I guess with that being said, I'm going to go, I guess we're me and Alan, right, are going to go ahead and get out of here, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye, guys.